www.mindfulbusinessclub.com.
Okay, the next question we are going to solve is, we are given three points and we have to show that they lie in a straight line. The question here is, given three points A31, show that the given points A31, B64 and C86 lie in a straight line. This is the question. We are given three points and their coordinates. We have to show that the given points lie in a straight line. See, here is a straight line. If there are three points here, A, here it is B, and here it is C, the coordinate of A is given to be 3, 1, and the coordinate of B is given to be 6, 4, and C is equal to 8, 6. If A, B and C are in a straight line, then the length of AB plus BC should be equal to the length of AC. Now we have to find the length of AB, BC and AC and check the relation AB plus BC is equal to AC. Is it true or not? We have to check. So find the length of AB. AB is equal to, in a problem, when we are doing a problem, write the formula once. So the distance formula is root of x2 minus x1 the whole square plus y2 minus y1 the whole square. Here it is. We are taking x1, y1 and this is x2, y2. 6, 4 is the point. Now, x2 minus x1 means 6 minus 3. 6 minus 3 the whole square plus y2 minus y1. It is 4 minus 1. 4 minus 1 the whole square. It is root of 6 minus 3 is equal to 3. So it is 3 square plus 4 minus 1 is also equal to 3. 3 square. So the value of AB is 9 plus 9. It is root 18. We can split it into 2 as 9 into 2. We are splitting 18 and into 9 into 2 because we are knowing the square root of 9. The square root of 9 is 3. So we are splitting it as 9 into 2. Therefore, the value is 3 root 2. Root of 9 is equal to 3 and inside the root radical sign there it is 2. Therefore, it is 3 root 2 units, the value of AB. Now we are going to find the length of BC. Length BC is equal to, again, same formula, root of x2 minus, it is already there, so no need to write again. x2 minus x1 the whole square plus y2 minus y1 the whole square. It is, here it is x2 ay2, so take it as x1 y1. Now x2 minus x1, 6 minus 8 the whole square plus y2 minus y1, 4 minus 6 the whole square. It is 6 minus 8 is equal to minus 2 square. Then 4 minus 6 is also minus 2. Minus 2 square is equal to plus 4. Again, minus 2 square is equal to plus 4. It is root 8. Again, we can split root 8 into 2 factors. Root 8 means it is root 4 into 2. 4, the root of square root of 4 is equal to 2 itself. And so the result is 2 root 2. We are getting the length of BC as 2 root 2. Now we have to find out the length of AC. The distance AC, length AC is equal to root of, here it is x1 y1, so take it as x2 y2. Now 8 minus 3 the whole square, 8 minus 3 the whole square, x2 minus x1 the whole square plus y2 minus y1, 6 minus 1 the whole square. 6 minus 1 the whole square. 8 minus 3 the whole square is equal to 5 square. Again 6 minus 1 the whole square is equal to 5 square. This is equal to root of 25 plus 25. 5 square is equal to 25. Then 25 plus 25 is equal to root 50. We can split 50 as 25 into 2. 10 into 5 is also equal to 50. Why you are not splitting 50 as 10 into 5? There is no square root for 10 and no square root for 5. So we are splitting 50 as 25 into 2 because 25 has square root. In the same way here, it is 4 into 2 because 4 has square root. Here also, we are getting 18. 16 into 3 is also 18. But we are not splitting 18 as 16 into 3 because 6 has no square root, 3 has no square root. But if we are splitting 18 as 9 into 2, we can find the value of root 9. Root 9 is 3. 9 has perfect square root. So, we are splitting 18 as 9 into 2. So, the value is 3 root 2. Here it is 2 root 2. And the square root of 25 is 5. Then inside the radical sign, it is root 2. So, AC, the length of AC is 5 root 2. Now, we have to check whether AB plus BC is equal to AC. Now, adding AB and BC, AB plus BC is equal to 3 root 2 plus 2 root 2. 3 root 2 plus 2 root 2 is equal to 5 root 2. 3 plus 2 is taking, root 2 is taking as common. Now 3 plus 2 into root 2, which is equal to 5 root 2 units. We got the value AB plus BC as 5 root 2 and AC is also equal to 5 root 2 units. That means AB plus BC is equal to AC. The meaning of this condition is that A, B and C lie in a straight line. That means A, B and C lie in a straight line. Hence, we proved the result. Okay. It's a good question. Most probably, they will ask this type of question for 2 marks. So, please note this type of questions and study well. Okay.